We're going to have a discussion about copyright and publishing, and we're going to do this by way of Dolly Parton and Beyoncé. So back in May of 2024, Rolling Stone called Dolly Parton's song Jolene the number one country song of all time. This is on their list of 200 greatest country songs of all time, okay? So I know you already know Beyoncé has done a cover of this on her album Cowboy Carter. And since Dolly Parton is the songwriter and she owns the publishing, she's gonna get to keep the songwriter and the publishing royalties. Yes, she is. So how is this a possibility? Well, let's talk about it. This is just a quick heads up. I am not a legal attorney or anything like that. Please seek a professional for any kind of a question that you may have. This is just for educational purposes only. Thank you so much. That is my disclaimer. So what Beyoncé has done is called a cover song. And a cover song is basically when any artist decides that they're going to redo somebody else's song. There's some famous ones that I'm sure we all know. Songs like Aretha Franklin's Respect, Ike and Tina Turner, they did Proud Mary. They got a lot of covers too. Aretha did a lot of covers as well. But once Aretha did it, is her song. So even though we associate some songs with artists and it's not their song that they wrote, what exactly makes the song the actual songwriter's song? What makes it theirs? That is where publishing comes in. So basically, what is publishing? In the music industry, publishing houses, they handle the creation, the legal protection, and the financial management of copyrights for songwriters' compositions. Think of publishing like if you had a recipe for a dish, okay? And somebody else takes your recipe, makes that same dish. Even if they add some different seasonings to the dish, it's still basically your dish. That's basically what publishing is. You own the recipe. It's yours, even if they make little changes to it. Publishers, they are the ones who are in charge of getting your song out there. They try to pitch it to places like getting your songs in films, getting your songs in TV shows, getting your songs even in video games. So they do have a lot of functions that they do as far as publishing is concerned. You can be your own self-publisher, but that is not what we're going to talk about today. You can look that up too. So is publishing the same as copywriting? Nope. You can think of copyright like owning the finished product. Okay, let me give you an example. So if you write a song, you automatically have the copyright now. If you want to register your copyright, which you should for your legal protection, you got to go to copyright.gov and do all of that. I can make a video later on showing you that process because I promise you it is not for the faint of heart. Copyright.gov, as far as registering your copyright, it is not user friendly, but that's all right. We still got to do it. Let's just say you wrote a song. It's your song, right? Me, Charles, and I say, ooh, I'm going to record your song. I can record your song. I can do whatever I'm going to do with it. So I record your song. I put your song out. I'm selling your song. I can copyright my finished version of the song, that version, the sound recording. But the song itself, that's your part. You got the recipe. So guess what? Songwriter royalties and the copyrights that are in that go to you. The actual finished product of that piece of work, I can copyright just the sound recording, but the songwriter part, you would still own it. Got it? I hope you got it. Copyrights don't last forever. There's typically like until the last songwriter who's credited to writing it passes away plus like 50, 60, 70 years, something like that. And then it enters into the public domain, which you can do whatever you want with it then because copyright has expired. I'll say it again, copyright.gov. That's gonna be your best bet for this. Before we move on, if you don't mind, just give this video a little like and go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It's free and I will appreciate it so much. We're friends now. So how does one who has written a song and all that good stuff get paid when your song gets played? That's where your performing rights organizations come in. PROs, that's what I'm going to call them going forward. And there are three of them in the United States that are the main three. We're going to go with ASCAP, A-S-C-A-P, BMI, and CSAC, that's S-E-S-A-C. Now, I think CSAC is invitation only, so you probably ain't getting in there. So your best two bits are going to be ASCAP and BMI. PROs are not publishers. They're basically the middle people who just collect your money and give it to you. So when your song gets airplay and all kinds of whatever kind of play, they're the ones who collect the royalties and pay them out on your behalf. And you know what? In the United States, on AM FM radio, if your song gets played, if you're the artist, the one who recorded it, you don't get any kind of an artist royalty for AM FM radio, terrestrial radio as some people call it, but the songwriters and the publishers do. Yeah, it's kind of good to get into songwriting and publishing, ain't it? Speaking of royalties, there's two types that I will talk about right now, and it's going to be mechanical and performance. Mechanical royalties are the ones you get when your song is reproduced, like on a physical CD or vinyl or cassette tape or a download from a music site. The performance royalties come whenever there's a live performance of that song. So those are the two that basically you'll be dealing with. Let me say this. Most things are negotiable, so if you do have a publishing contract, make sure you get the right amount of money. You won't slice up the pie correctly. So whatever kind of contract or whatever negotiations that you need to deal with that up front so that you will be satisfied in the end, okay? Like I said, this is not legal advice. This just make good sense. Earlier, I mentioned Dolly Parton, Beyonce, and Jolene. What's so significant about them? Well, here's this. Speaking of songwriters and publishers, I told you Dolly owns the song, right? When Beyonce did the recording, even though she changed some lyrics, she added a bridge and everything, guess what? I told you, she added her own seasonings to the mix. She still kept Dolly Parton as the sole songwriter. She the only one. So guess what? Dolly's gonna get all those royalties. Yes, she is. Merry Christmas, Dolly. Recording somebody else's song is a great way to pay tribute to that artist, and it's good to know that there are measures in place so that the original artists and songwriters do get what is due to them monetarily. Even if you do your own music, it's just great to know about publishing and copywriting, just in case somebody else may want to do your song. It's just good knowledge to have. I hope that I've said something here that was meaningful and beneficial to you. And one more thing I want to throw out at you. Have you ever noticed so many singers have YouTube channels? I'm sure you have. I have a whole video talking about why you should have your own YouTube channel. I'm going to put something up on the screen somewhere for you to click on it, and I'll see you over in that video.